a story of a centurion whose servant, he considered this servant as a son or daughter. Siya ay napaka-special sa kanya. At ang sabi ng King James Version, meron siyang palsy. And palsy is uncontrollable shaking. You are losing control of yourself at nanginginig. At kahit gusto na niyang magpahinga, hindi siya makapagpahinga at payat na payat at hindi makakain, and he's dying really. So this centurion is really bothered, and he did something drastic that opened our eyes and what is great faith. To begin with, when Jesus entered into Capernaum, there came unto him a centurion beseeching him and saying, "Lord, my servant lieth at home sick of the palsy, and he is grievously tormented." And Jesus said unto him, "I will come and heal him." The centurion answered, "Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof." He said, and here is the word that I love, "Just speak the word, and my servant will be healed. I am a man under authority, having soldiers under me, and I say this, go and he goeth, come and he cometh, do and he doeth." When Jesus heard it, he marveled. During his time ministering to the Jews, no person ever said that. So he said, "I have not found so great faith in Israel." And Jesus said unto the centurion, "Go thy way, as thou hast believed, so be it unto thee." And his servant was healed in that self same hour. Makikita natin dito yung humility. Pero may isang bagay na nakita siya. Nakita niya yung kabutihan ng Diyos. Faith works at its best when you see the unconditional love of God, not your love, because your love will fall short. If your point of view is to love God with all your heart, mind, and soul, then you're using the law and you will fall short. Because no one can love God with all their heart apart from the love of God flowing in them. The Bible says, "He worketh for us to act and to will according to His purpose." It is God doing it from beginning to end. And the Bible says that He is just and the justifier. He did the work for us by giving His Son to justify us. It means it's all His doing. None of us. It's all of Him. It's the moment we believe the gospel, we die to our old self. That old man has been crucified more than 2,000 years ago. Today, the life we live in the flesh, according to Galatians 2:20, we live by the faith of Jesus. It's the faith of Jesus that works in us. Because the covenant is between Jesus. And today, we are under the dispensation of grace. That we might be justified by the faith of Christ, and not by the works of the law, for by the works of the law shall no flesh be justified. So, by the faith of Jesus Christ, even we have believed in Jesus Christ. Here's the thing. By believing in Jesus, we believe in His faith. Why faith of Jesus? Let's go to Philippians. He said, isinantabi niya ang kanyang pagka-Diyos at hindi siya pumantay sa Diyos. Naging siyang masunurin hanggang sa siya'y maipako sa krus. Magkaganon, binigyan siya ng pinakamataas na pangalan, that is the name above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. He fulfilled the law that we cannot fulfill. He lived the life that we cannot live. He received the death that we deserve. He received the chastisement and punishment that all humanity deserve. When He shouted, "Tetelestai," it is finished. You cannot lessen or diminish this. What is left for us to do is to just rest and believe. You are not called born again. You're not called Christian. In fact, the word Christian only mentioned once. But we are called believers, and it was mentioned many times in the Bible. Why believers? Why not Christian? Why not born again? Why? Because we are called to believe for everything that the Lord already gave for us. We work hard, but we don't work hard on our own. We work hard through the strength of Jesus. You cannot be sanctified and holy through your works. Holiness is a gift. Holiness and love are on the same side. Because in His love, He gave you the gift of righteousness. If you study the writings of John the Beloved, truth is always on the side of grace. And here is the truth. You will know the truth and the truth will set you free. Ibig sabihin ng truth doon, ang pinalaya ni Kristo ay tunay nangang malaya. Paano ka naging malaya? Ito yon. Nung namatay si Kristo, kasama mo siyang namatay. Nung nailibing siya, kasama mo siyang nailibing para walang maisumbat ang diablo o sino man sa iyong mga kasalanan. At nung siya'y muling nabuhay, kasama mo siyang muling nabuhay at isa kang bagong nilalang kung ikaw ay naniwala sa Ebanghelyo. That is the gospel. The only way that God can set us free from sin is to crucify our old self. And our old self has been crucified. You don't need to crucify yourself over and over again. You just have to live by faith and believe that. Because His Word has power to transform life. And He gave life to you the moment you believe. And the Bible says, He that is dead is freed from sin. Freed from sin, not freed to sin. We are for the law, but we are for the law the way it is intended. Because if you are still using the law to mortify your body, you are under curse. And the favor of God will not flow. That's why it's very important for you to understand that it's the faith of Jesus that is in you. You don't exercise your faith. You don't need like the faith of the mustard seed. You have the faith of Jesus. The moment you realize that you have the faith of God, you remove the wall. Yes, I don't need to strive. I don't need to struggle. I don't need to make an extra effort to receive. I just need to put my faith in Jesus through His faith that He manifested before the Father. It is the faith of Jesus working in you, not your ability to believe. Great faith is not having great faith, but it is having a full confidence on the faithfulness of God no matter what, that the Bible declares, even if we are unfaithful, He will remain faithful to us because He cannot disown Himself.